Hey, this is Sonny James with Serato here in Los Angeles. I'm here to help you learn the things that you need to know in order to maximize usage of Serato DJ Pro. In this video, I'll be showing you how to mix music using practice mode. This can be a helpful tool for preparation and working out ideas on the go before it's game time. You can either listen using your laptop speakers by using your 1/8-inch output jack or USB audio interface connected to external speakers or just with headphones. So let's open Serato DJ Pro and double check that our layout is set to view two decks by clicking here. If you press the track control tab below the virtual crossfader, you'll be able to see cue points, manual and auto loops, beat jump if you have enabled them to show, and flip if you have that expansion. You'll notice you have 8 cue point slots for each deck. If you check in settings and visit the library and display tab, you can change the cue pad layout to performance pad view, which mimics the look of most DJ hardware you'll be connecting to. Load a track to your left deck by dragging it. There are also hotkeys available for a quicker workflow. By pressing Shift and the left arrow key for the left deck, and Shift plus the right arrow key for the right deck. Slide the crossfader here to your left side to cut off sound coming in from the right deck. Next, start your first track by pressing the play button on the left deck. Using your keyboard, you can also press the W key or space bar to start and stop the left deck. Load your second track in a similar range to the BPM playing and match the tempos either by pressing sync on the deck you are mixing in or by using the tempo slider. I'm going to use sync here for a quicker workflow. Start the second track by pressing the S key or enter on your keyboard. Use cue points to trigger the tracks in. I always set a cue point at the beginning of my track so I can quickly jump back to the start. You can also use the temporary cue, and this will bring the track back to the start and stop it. To accomplish this, press the I and K keys on your keyboard. I will correspond to the temporary cue on the left deck and K for the right. It's important to note that temporary cue does not save to the file and will be gone next time you load the track. On each deck, there are volume up faders and corresponding input gain meters. You can use the volume up faders to fade up and down the volume of the track that's playing on the computer with your mouse. If you want to adjust the gain, you can do so with the track gain adjust. The general rules are to stay in green and yellow and avoid red as this may cause distortion. In addition, you can use the key lock or pitch and time DJ if you have a license for it to maintain the key of the song while changing the tempo. Once you have your tempos matched, bring the crossfader back to the center to mix in your new track.
No matter how you use Serato DJ Pro in practice mode, there are options to help you feel prepared and confident to step in a DJ booth and get to work. For more information, check out Serato.com and the other videos in this series, which will be diving even deeper into what's possible with Serato DJ Pro. See you soon.